I give her my blessings.
She has this natural charisma.
She is the best chance that we have.
In 2004, Maria Gracia Cielo Padaca, or Grace for short, became the first woman governor of Isabela, the second largest province in the Philippines. Grace toppled the D family dynasty who had ruled the province for 40 years. Grace's childhood was unlike that of her friends. Hit by polio at the age of 3, she relied on her books from an early age. A consistent honor student, Grace became a certified public accountant, worked as a radio broadcaster for 14 years, and at 41, she describes herself as a happy, certified single woman. Politics in the Philippines is still a male-dominated arena. Women have gained little ground. At the local level, the ratio of elected government officials is about one elected woman for every 7 men.
Maybe, partly, because it's still a macho, predominantly macho society. And among the 36 mayors of my province, I think there are 32 men.
Women are few in politics because traditionally our thinking is that men is superior to women. And it's only recent that women began asserting their leadership. And it's a welcome development because women are brilliant. Women are brilliant. They have a way of settling things. They're a way of doing things that men cannot do as efficient as the women does.
Isabela province is 400 kilometers north of Manila. It's made up of 35 municipalities, 2 cities, and a population of about 1.4 million people. Here, agriculture predominates, but there are also vast natural parks, forests, wildlife, and a long coastline. And until now, the province has always been ruled by men. Winning a political seat in the Philippines is not easy, especially if you are a newcomer without the support of a political party, or like Grace, you are simply a woman. Grace won her seat, but she still has to prove her worth.
I managed to win despite the fact that I did not have any money because the people felt that they were part of the struggle. And when people stopped fighting, it was when the powers that be started to feel they were already invincible, that no one can ever defeat them. Power corrupts, and absolute power corrupts absolutely.
I don't mind a woman leading this province or even the nation, as long as we can make things work. And I feel that under the leadership of Governor Grace, things are working well.
I think the bigger difference is how the male former governor and governors and the present female would look at their position as positions of service rather than a position of advantage in exploiting.
Agriculture is my flagship project because when I ran, my campaign line was freedom for Isabela, freedom from poverty, freedom from our own selves, from our own wrong practices, our wrong values. I said that my physical disability may be the easiest disability of all because there is also the disability of being always afraid of being cowards. There's a disability of being lazy, disability of being gossips, and disability of not doing things for yourself. So I said we should be freed from this. So there should be a new culture, more focus on the small people, on our farmers.
Medyo nakakapon naman ng sa mga magsasaka.
We farmers are happy. Our governor has brought in foreign traders to buy our crops. Without her help, we would still be at a disadvantage because the local traders buy our crops at a lower price.